Hello everybody, let's welcome Babaji today. He is a new rage on YouTube. He runs the channel Exotic Astrology. He's having nearly 900 videos of astrology on YouTube. Babaji, welcome.
Thank you so much for...
It's an honor. So Babaji ji, since when are you doing astrology?
I'm loosely into all these Vedic sciences from almost, I would say 2002. So it's almost around 17, 18 years. And from 2010, much more deeply, I would say. And I started the channel in YouTube on March 2017. So it's like 2.5 years.
Okay, and so many videos since that 2 years.
Yeah.
That's a great achievement.
Thank you, thank you.
And so what would you like to speak about today?
So today I was wondering if we can speak something on Ashtakvarga. So recently I made many videos on my channel on Ashtakvarga.
Yes, I have applied on Ashtakvarga on marriage. On many charts.
Okay.
And I found it to be correct. The technique you are using, I have found it to be correct.
Oh, okay. Oh, nice to know that. Thank you. Mm. Yeah, so I did for different topics, but I have not done like many, or I've done one video, but now I will show the entire analysis, how to do for the whole life analysis. Okay, not individually like marriage or career or childbirth or health or something like that.
It's a total chart.
Yes, so what I will do is I will take one example chart and I will show all the areas of life, and then I will show you how you can combine the different houses and different meanings and the different events, because for astrology, as you know, for one event there is no event where there is only one house involved. There are multiple houses are involved. So, and then I will briefly touch on the dashas and transits also, which we can use or we can see using Ashtakvarga. But that is a very big and a very broad topic. And for that, for seeing transits, we need to see the Kakshaya slot of the different planets. And I was very fortunate to record on Kakshaya slot yesterday with Nitin Kashyap ji from Astro Life Sutras. So I will release that video very soon on my channel, so where you can see how using the Kakshaya slot for the degrees of planets, you can get an idea of the transits, okay? So about transits, I will not speak much here, but all the other things I will hopefully cover in this video. Okay. And before I start, thank you very much for the invitation. And I also came to know that you are a big expert in KP astrology. So maybe we can also record together, because there's nobody who has done any video in my channel on KP. So
maybe... I would rather do Nari.
Okay, yeah, that is also unknown zone in my
channel. So, yes.
Yeah, so we can start with you only very soon. Okay, so I will just share the screen now. Just give me a second. Okay, can you see the screen?
Yes.
All right. So this is the chart of one of my friends. So I took her chart. So this is a very interesting chart. I will tell you why. I mean, you will come to know as we proceed in the video. It's a bit of a polar chart. You know, there are extremities in this chart. Okay. So let us just first see the Lagna chart here. So this is a Libra ascendant with these four planets in the ascendant. So generally, I have seen if there are too many planets in the ascendant, then either the person is too much opinionated or the person gets confused by the opinions of others. because the ascendant is the intelligence, and when these four planets are sitting, it's like this person will always keep listening to what these planets say. Okay, so here if you see, Sun is the 11th lord here, then again Mars is the second lord, so and the seventh lord also. So the conception of family is very strongly inculcated in the ascendant itself. And Saturn as the fourth lord is also aspecting this ascendant. So that's what the chart is. And this is the Navamsha chart, which you can see on the side. So with moon in the ascendant, which makes her a very good singer. And she is into medical profession. She's a doctor. And moon is very good if it is in trines for any doctor. And last year, Vishti Larsen had come to my channel. He had spoken elaborately on planets in trines of Navamsha. So there he specifically mentioned that if moon is in the trines, then it can give a person the ability to understand other people. So it makes a great doctor. Okay. I mean, that's good if it is there in doctors, but it does not mean that anybody who has moon in trines will become a doctor.
Because moon is compassion, so maybe that's.
Yeah, exactly, exactly. And there are many other things which we can see in this chart, but today's focus is on using Ashtak Varga. And she's currently running her Saturn Mahadasha. And she is running Saturn Venus now currently. And after some time, very soon I would say, Venus Antardasha is going to be over on 18th of November this year. And then Sun Antardasha will start. Okay. All right. So currently she has finished her MBBS and she's pursuing masters in radiology. Okay, I don't know exactly what that is, but this is what she told me some time back. And maybe after one year or 1.5 years, she will go into some professional area and do something there. Okay, so now let us go to the Ashtak Varga table, which you can see on the right here. This is the table. And I'll just pull this here so that the numbers are clearly visible. I hope you can see all the numbers.
Yes.
Okay, so this Ashtak Varga table, as many of us know, these are the points which are there in all of these houses. So there are many misconceptions about Ashtak Varga scores. So for example, one of the biggest misconception is that 28 is like the barometer. So anything which is above 28 is wonderful. Life is great, stupendous, out of the world. You are in the heavens. And anything less than 28, you know, you are suffering like as if you are in hell. Okay. So it is actually not like that. And surprisingly, it has nothing to do with the numbers. Okay. In fact, last week I was also talking to Nitin Kashyapji on this, in this regard of the numbers. And then in fact, he was also telling me that in fact, it is better to have equal numbers in all the houses. Okay. Because if any house has, you know, like 40, 50 points, then from where will the points come? It will not drop from the sky.
Yeah,
you have to suck.
From the other house.
Yeah, so generally now this is something which I will say here, and this has to be understood after seeing the whole chart. But in my experience, I have seen if people have certain houses with too many numbers, you know, like very high numbers, then what I have seen is they very easily go into depression. Okay. Why does that happen? Because they are trying to fulfill some other house through this house. Okay. So it's like a vacuum which they are trying to fill through something else in their life. Okay. So now, of course, that's not a rule, but this is something which I've seen from my experience. And apart from that, I have also seen that, like, for example, in certain areas of life, there are some combined houses. Okay, so for example, if you've seen this chart, we know the Artha houses, the second house, sixth house, and the 10th house. And 11th house is also very important because it's the house of gains. So if you see in this chart, there are maximum points here. You see in the 6th house, in the 10th house, and in the 11th house. Okay. So that means these three houses will kind of act like that pumping machine for the rest of the chart. Okay. So what I have seen is, if there are too many points in certain related houses, you know, then these houses become like the shield, you know, defense, as is in Hindi, they say, dhal. So if you ask them any question regarding to any area of their house, they will bring that armor, you know. Okay.
So for example, sensitive about.
Yeah, they kind of tend to pretend that everything is great in my life because these houses are great. Okay. So for example, as you can see in this chart, the fourth house has very less points, okay, 24 points now. And the seventh house also has 24 points, which according to that traditional subject is like not very good. So, and if you see here, second house also has very less points, okay, according to that 28 rule. So here with this person, one of the biggest challenges will be whatever, see, the second, fourth and seventh deal with your family and your inner life. Okay. So now this person will have a tendency to compensate the issues or problems in the family or married life by the armor of, you know, career, name, fame, status, power, position. Okay. So if somebody asks her, you know, oh, so how's your family life? She will say, you know, family is not that good, but my career is great. It's like a defense, you know, it's like an armor. Okay.
So inherently, the house that is having more points is focused more, no? Yeah?
Yeah, so
they'll
it's
give
like,
more focus to that point. Then.
Yeah, so yes, so now see, suppose here in if the 10th house would have around 28 points, for example, and then the 11th house would be having 40 points. The second house, okay. So then now this is something very peculiar I have seen with the 11th house. The 11th house will flow, it always flows with the other houses because it is the house of gain. So it gives you gains with whichever houses it is linked to. So if the second house would have had more points, then this would not be necessarily financial. I think it will be more of that family oriented gain, you know, more focus on the family, something like that. Okay. And similarly, if it was more on the seventh house, it would be more on the marriage side. Okay. But then marriage and family will become like defense. Any problem is there in my life? Oh, I will focus on my marriage. I will focus on my family. Okay, so either ways, you know, it's like a defense mechanism which the person creates around himself or herself for any issues in life. And so now we will start with this. So I'll pull this here. And if you can see, first we always start from the ascendant. So now we may be thinking, oh my God, there are four planets in the ascendant, you know. But there are only 26 points in astrology. Okay, so now if you go now again, this is many people get confused with this. So when I say the first house, it is this house, and you do not have to go here. This is Aries. Okay, number one, you have to go to seven, which is Libra. Okay, so here if you go and see, you will come to know what is happening. So now you see here, Sun is giving 3 points, Moon is giving 2 points, then Mars has 3, now Mercury has some points, and Jupiter has the highest contribution. Jupiter is 7 points, okay. And then Venus has descent, and Saturn has 2 points. All right, so now the thing is, the planet which is contributing the maximum is Jupiter for this person, okay. So this essentially means that among the four planets which are placed in the Lagna, Jupiter will be the one who is impacting her the most. Okay. Now that's the tricky situation here. If you see sign-wise, Jupiter is not very well placed. Jupiter is in Libra. Jupiter doesn't, he would
Yes.
be the last person to sit there. Especially in signs like Libra and Gemini is like the other side, and Aquarius is still decent enough. But
Right.
Libra and Gemini are very, I mean, they are signs where Jupiter would be not very much interested to sit there. But here, that's the funny thing, you see. But Jupiter is contributing the highest amount of points here. So it is like saying this Jupiter, which is not so very happy to sit there in the ascendant, I mean in Libra, will finally end up taking a lot of her attention and a lot of her focus, okay, regarding the things which she listens to in anybody, when anybody tells her, okay. And now you also have to see which houses this Jupiter is ruling. So Jupiter is ruling the third house and it rules the sixth house. Okay. So that means now she always has a complaint, and she was asking me one day that why does this happen always? And then I asked her what is that complaint. She says that, as I said, she's a doctor. So she said that whenever she's in her profession or her career front in the hospital, then always some other ladies, okay, some other ladies will end up telling her wrong things, or will end up cheating her, or they will guide her in a wrong direction, and it appears that they are right, but somehow she gets misled by these senior ladies or the other female doctors. So she was asking me why does that happen, and she was also asking me that always it happens that there are only ladies surrounding me in the team, and they are also very much senior or elder to me, you know, that kind of.
Yeah.
So then I told her regarding this. I'll just close this. Okay. So then I told her that the thing is here, Jupiter is in Libra, you see. So sixth lord can show your circumstances when you are working. And now Jupiter is in Libra for you. So that means again the female thing is visible. Okay. Females surrounding you in your workplace. And because that has so high,
So
maximum
many
points
points.
that is having a very strong say in your life. But now the thing is it becoming good for you? That will be dependent on how much well-placed Jupiter is in the chart. Okay. Now Jupiter is in Libra and he's not that happy there. Okay, so therefore this can create some challenges, and I had suggested her to do some mantra for Vyasdev, and I have to take an update from her how things are. Of course she has to do that mantra for at least I would say minimum 12 years, I would say. Then maybe we can see some better things happening for her. So this is something which I have seen now. Of course, Sun is sitting there, Mercury is sitting, Mars is also sitting. Now, if you see here, Mercury has 5 points there. Okay. So Mercury is the next contender for this house. And Mercury is the ninth lord here. It is also the 12th lord. And it is as a trinal lord, it will definitely do some good. Okay. So now Mercury represents your friends, okay, and Mercury is in Libra. Libra is a great sign for Mercury to be in. Okay. So then she also told me that my friends are the one who takes me out of these issues. Okay, somehow my friends will come and, you know, they will help me out of nowhere. They will just pop up. Okay, because now see, if you take the concept of Digbala, planets get a
Mercury,
Digbala.
yes, Mercury is
Yeah, so Mercury and Jupiter both are in
a
Digbala.
difficult.
Okay, So now it is like saying Digbala means like to what extent external situations will affect you. Okay, so this Jupiter in Libra, this problem is pulling her quite a bit, and Mercury's help is also there. But now the question is, who wins the match ultimately? So this is like saying, although Jupiter's effect is very strong in this person's ascendant, you know, because it has 7 points here. But because Mercury is still contributing, so she will be able to solve these issues which are coming because of Jupiter. Okay, so Jupiter represents the guidance which you get. Okay, so when Jupiter is not well placed as here, then you can always get wrong guidance. You know, you want some, like you are some patient has come and somebody directs you to some wrong person, and you know you end up doing some wrong treatment or something. That. And
so
she always felt,
what if Mercury had only 2 or 3 points over here? It is in the friend's house, it is Digbali.
Yes.
Then what it would have done?
Oh, then the friends would have not been able to help her too much. Even now she does not tell me that all the problems are solved because of the friends. Okay. That would have happened if Mercury would have, you know, maybe 7 points or maybe 6 points or maybe even more than that, even
Jupiter
better.
Jupiter less than Mercury.
Yeah, and now the predicament is Jupiter has the highest amount of points in Astaworld. Okay, so if Jupiter is having some issues in the chart, then in Astaworld it really becomes a challenging issue. Okay.
Yeah. So this
and
is completely new point I've
Yeah, and the other thing is Jupiter is primarily the third lord because the Mool Trikon sign is Sagittarius. It is falling here in the third house. And that is also sitting in the Lagna, and no wonder why she's always into issues related to documents. Okay. So some patient will come and tell her, oh, you told me to, you wrote this in the prescription and I bought this. When I went to buy this, then the pharmaceutical people told me that, oh, this is a wrong tablet. You are having this disease. Why is the doctor suggesting this? Go and, you know, go and take it again. Okay. So, and then what she does is she goes to some of her seniors and she will, you know, ask, oh, what is the problem? And then the senior will rectify. You know, this Mercury is the ninth lord senior and it is also retrograde. So it's like going to the senior again and again and asking, you know, what is wrong? And then, but the thing is, she's clueless. She can't understand that how can I do such mistakes, you know, writing writing the wrong names. Okay, so I also told her to do some mantra for Mercury also, so I hope the situation improves one day. but she's very talented. She's very 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 talented and she's very intelligent, because you can see this fifth lord Saturn is in the fourth house. So I have always seen this. Whenever the fourth and the fifth and the ninth are linked, the person is very intelligent somehow. Because fourth house is the house of your education and ability to grasp knowledge. And five and nine represents the blessings in the chart. So the fifth house is your intelligence or ninth house is the intelligence of the guru. So either you figure it out yourself, the fifth house is involved, or if the ninth lord is involved, then the guru comes and tells you. And here Mercury as the ninth lord is also in the Lagna.
Yes.
And undoubtedly, sign-wise, Mercury is the most powerful because Sun and Mars are also not very interested to sit in signs like Libra.
Right.
I mean, Jupiter, needless to say. And therefore, Mercury's power is very, it's the highest, I would say. Okay, but then again, in Astak Varga, you see a different story. Okay, so this issue with Jupiter will always be the prominent issue in her life. Okay, so this is like saying, because this is the Lagna and the sixth lord is involved, so it's like half of our daily time will go in this this thing that, oh, somebody has given me some wrong guidance, okay, some senior lady or some elder, somebody like that. Now, if this was not in the ascendant, maybe this was in some other house, okay, then what would happen? This would not consume so much of our energy. Then this would be like, okay, there's a problem, it's fine, there's no issue with that. But because this is in the ascendant, this is causing a lot of challenges for her. Okay. And then many times people say, how do we judge Rahu and Ketu's placements, you know, and using Ashtavarga there. So Rahu and Ketu are very interesting planets. They give results of many other planets also.